wisconsingarden.com. Back a few years ago when we just started and we were wisconsingarden.net, we did about 300 videos, and in the very early ones, some of our visitors said that they had difficulty understanding what I was saying, hearing. And so Rick, as his learning curve has improved and his talents have increased, decided that he would go back and redo them to enhance their quality. This is one of those videos. We hope you enjoy it. Give us a thumbs up if you've learned something and can appreciate them. Bye. Hi, from Lynn, wisconsingarden.org. I am looking at my gourds. I love to grow gourds. These are barrel gourds. The leaves are so soft. It's like velvet almost. And I planted six seeds this spring, and you can see that they have absolutely taken over. They're over right now, they're over the evergreen bushes and more. They've climbed way up into the trees, and you can see them hanging there. These gourds are just amazing. I have one right here above my head. Then if you look over there, there's another one. And there are, what do we say, five or six of them. One of them way, way, way up in there. It has to be at least 20, 25 feet up in the air. We didn't even know they were here. We had no idea. They were all over the place. And as the stems, as the vines started dying out, I was taking them out, only to realize that over here, there was a vine climbing up the tree. So I looked up, and all of a sudden, there they all are, hanging in the tree. Now, we're just going to leave them up there for this winter, because they have to dry. If you hadn't seen my gourd art, go back and look at a couple of the previous videos way back toward the beginning, and I have a video about my artwork that I do on the gourds. But they have to dry for an entire year. Unfortunately, if you leave them on the ground or in a screen porch or something, sometimes the mice or the squirrels get in there and they eat the seeds out and make holes. These are going to be perfect because they're up there hanging. There's nothing to interfere with them drying perfectly. So I'm going to be really excited. I don't know how we're going to get them down, but that's for next spring. I won't worry about it.
Well, you're also going to show what happens after the first frost.
Right. Now, after the first frost, which we still haven't had, all of the leaves will be gone. And then you'll be able to see exactly how many gourds actually grew during the summer. That doesn't mean that I will have all these gourds to work on, because as they dry, sometimes they just get mushy and rotten and you can't use them. And sometimes, depending on their growing season, they haven't developed enough to get hard. So it's a surprise every year. But there are some over here too. Remember, this is six seeds, but you see how beautiful and huge they are. Hopefully these will work out. These are almost basketball size, and that's the size they're supposed to get. Well, here we are on a cooler fall day, and it's now getting down to the 30s and 40s at night, and today it's maybe in the high 50s. But last we spoke, I had all of these gourd vines growing all over with hidden gourds, and I was going to do a video on how I was cleaning them up. But we had this really nice day one day, and Rick was in the house working, and I suddenly just had the compulsion to come out here and clean up the gourd vines. So I did, and lo and behold, I found 18 gourds hiding amongst the vines. And I found some bushes that needed trimming, so I trimmed that bush over there. And then this bush down here, which was totally hidden by the gourd vines. And the other ones that are hanging up in the tree are still hanging. They seem to be coming down a little bit, but we'll just leave them up there for now, see what happens. But as you can see, the leaves are falling down onto the ground, and pretty soon these will be covered with leaves as they get blown around, and we'll see how many last until next spring. You never know. It's a surprise every time. One of my true passions is gourds. Gourds grow in the ground. They are hollow inside, just a few seeds, and you can create many things from them. The Indians and the native peoples use them for drinking and for bottles. This is how they look after one winter of drying. These were grown in our garden last year. They had to harden, they had to get moldy on them, and then when you are ready to work on them, you have to scrub all of that off. But when you do, you see that there's a pattern on there that nature has created. And those are the patterns that I use with my artwork when I draw on them and I color them in. So it's quite a change from the old skin that's coming off and the clean white underskin that's underneath there.
And talk about the baths that you have to, you know, in your preparation after
Over the years I've tried to figure out the best way of getting this old skin off. Sometimes it likes to just peel off, but that would take forever. But it does peel off on some of the gourds. What I've done lately, the last couple of times, is I put them into a plastic, old plastic milk crate. And I take the hose, and with as high a pressure as I can get, I spray them off, and that helps loosen up all of the old skin. Then when I can't get any more off with the sprayer, then I take them out and I put them in a bucket of water with soap. And I take a brush and I scrub them off. After I take the brush and scrub them, then I take wet sandpaper, specially made sandpaper for using with wetness, and I scrub them again until they get, now this one I haven't done yet, but it gives you an idea, until I get this, the surface that has no layers on it anymore. Then, in order to keep them from getting moldy after I've done this, because that's what does cause the patterns, but you don't want mold growing on them when they're a piece of artwork, I have to take another bath with the gourds. I don't take a bath with the gourds. The gourds take a bath in water and chlorine bleach. Just a little bleach, not too much. But you want to kill any of the mold bacteria that might be growing on there and prevent any new stuff from starting. Then they have to dry thoroughly. Some of them, like this poor guy, has a hole in. I can still use it for a different project, but if there's any seepage inside there, you need to let it dry out, even if you're not going to take the innards out, if you're going to leave it whole. Because again, you don't want mold growing through, and if you've done something to the outside, decorated it, and then varnished it, and there's still moisture inside, that will ruin all your artwork. So drying is so important, because you have to stop the process before it can be a workable surface. Then you have to have storage for all of your gourds, because you keep collecting them. Now here is a little storage area down here that has some of my smaller gourds that I haven't gotten to yet. There's a few more smaller ones, but also curly ones. And then out here, my husband has indulged me by buying me a huge outdoor container. So inside this are gourds that are thoroughly dried. These, some of them we've bought, some of them we have grown ourselves. But here's my treasure trove. And sometimes I keep some of my extras that I might add on to gourds as they finish up. And I see we have a little pest that's trying to build a nest in there. Have to take care of him.
Two of them.
Yikes.
Leave it open.
Indeed.
We'll take care of it right now.
These are what the gourds look like when I get finished with them. You can take the little bumpy ones that you buy at the grocery store in the fall. Little egg gourds. This is called the crown of thorn gourds. And I did these 1 year right around Christmas time. This is called the little bottle gourd. So each one has its own pattern depending on what the mold made as a pattern.
Kind of like a wood grain.
Some of them are. This is a bumpy gourd. I chose to leave the bumps free but colored in the background. So each one has its own personality. Each one has its own pattern. I got some of these just reminded me of faces. So this, although it has no face, it has the beginnings of a head with hair and a feather. This is one of my latest ones, a spirit gourd. This one is one that celebrates the seasons, spring, summer, fall, and winter. And this was just a crazy, crazy bird gourd. I made a pile of eggs, but people tell me it looks like something else, so it's movable. That's what I do for fun in the winter, and so far it's entertained me a lot.
As it does me.
So now I'm going to have a whole row of little people looking at us while we're eating dinner. Bye for now.